Good morning, everybody. Thanks for coming to my talk on furniture value chains. And this morning you heard from the Peter Holmgren on the green economy. And the green economy, we aim to further mainstream sustainable development. We aim to reduce carbon emission first. Second one, we aim also to improve natural resource management by more sustainable in terms of production as well as consumption. And the last one is very, very important. We aim to improve livelihood of everybody, livelihood of people. Here we try to eradicate poverty and sustaining job for everybody. And related to that, furniture that I would like to share with you is the most labor-intensive industry in forestry. Million people in the world, million people in Indonesia really depend on furniture industry. And now, in Indonesia in particular, in Java Island in particular, the industry of furniture is in stagnant. And means that the growth is not good enough, the growth of furniture industry. So CIFOR and its partner has been doing action research, try to improve livelihood of small-scale producer, as well as try to sustain the furniture industry. By at least we have five scenarios how to improve the livelihood of small-scale producer. First is try to get closer the small-scale industry, the small-scale enterprises, try to get closer to the buyers. So we call it this kind of scenario is moving up, because most value added of furniture industry, most value added of furniture products lies on the marketing and also design. If you are closer to the buyer, it means you will get a better value added. That's the first one. The second one is having a better association. The association among small scale enterprise. Why? Because if you collaborate with kind of you, if you have a better bargaining power in terms of negotiation with the big guys, with the bigger furniture industry, you will get a better price in terms of selling your product, selling the furniture product. So we are in Jepara in particular, where we are doing action research, is try to establish, to facilitate the establishment of small scale producer association. The third one is, I think this is the very, very most important in our research, is strengthening or even establishing small scale producer organization. Because, you know, they alone is nothing. It's very, very small. Only one producer with 10 labor and very, very small scale. But together, in Jepara, for instance, they have 12,000 small scale producer. And we were there actually to develop organization, association that conducive to their aspiration. So it's very important to have a small scale producer. And also the fourth scenario is a green furniture. As mentioned by Peter Holmgren yesterday, it's a green economy. But what happened on the ground is how to make it happen. Because the question on the ground is not what, but how to do it. How to do it is very, very important. And we work together with them to take advantage with the SVLK, the legal timber certification, the subsidy, the also the endorsement from government to work with them to get the SVLK certificate, the timber legality certificate. This is the fourth scenario. The last one, to ensure the sustainability of our outputs as our outcomes, have our impact. We work at the policy level. So we work together with the local government to develop the district regulation to ensure that the government at the local level, at the subnational level, to support the small scale producer. And now the regulation is on the parliament, but most of the political party support this kind of regulation. This is at the subnational level, but also we was very happy because at the national level, they heard what we are doing at the local level, they heard by the national policy makers. So most of them are invited to the national policy processes. And also as a back to the small scale organization and moving up closer to the buyers, they are invited not only to Jakarta, but also to Guangzhou, to China, also to Mumbai, sponsored by them, it's not by us, sponsored by organization in India and also by in China to sell their products. So based on this kind of activities, this kind of outcomes, we have several impacts. First, I think it's the most important impact is statistically proven we can improve their incomes. Those who join the organization, those who join the certification have better income, better money, rather than those who do not join the association. The second one is more thick planted forest. As evidence on the ground, they planted thick more now. Yeah. So we can see the 2 years old thick in Jepara in Central Java due to our intervention. And the third one is important, they produce green furniture for international market, also try to for domestic market, because now it's a domestic market, it's not very sensitive to the certification. But they produce green furniture. I think it's important to try to do it. And the lesson learned for the this research, first is, it's very, very important for us to do research by having the baseline study. So we can compare at the beginning of our research with the end of our research and see the difference. And also very important to have, to understand the question on the ground is not what, but how to do it. Because FAO for a long time endorsed the importance of the producer organization. But the question is how to do it on the ground. And we envision coming up to have to scale up the research, not only working in Central Java, but working in the Southeast Asia. I and Andrew visited Vietnam last month to try to have this kind of research, and also to understand the log flow in Indonesia. 1 minute more. And I would like also to share with you, there are three theories that we are working on. I like the theory. First is the theory from Jürgen Habermas. He's the great German philosopher, called the communicative action theory. If you want to change on the ground, it's not by talking, it's not by negotiation, but by action on the ground. If do action on the ground, it will endorse the reciprocal action from others. The second theory is called the social ecological system from Elinor Ostrom. So understand actually the institution on the ground. And also the last theory, we call it the complexity theory, I think as Robert Lovett, that the property at the system level is not necessarily having clear connection with the property at the component level. So this is the property, system level property, this is a component level property. It's not necessarily clear connection. There's many, many emergent phenomena at the system level. It's difficult sometimes to find out what happened out at the component level. I have a background of modeler. I like this kind of theory. Okay, thank you, Robert. Thank you.
The silviculture management was slightly a problem also. Maybe also the germ plasma used in those plantations. Has any improvement taken place in recent years on those two aspects?
Yes, about tick, I think as Pak Putra could comment about the tick germplasm. So now we have a species that we can harvest after 5 years. We call it the Jati Unggul Nusantara as a clone for tick, as a produced by Perhutani, the state-owned company. And also we can easily buy actually the Solomon tick. The Solomon tick is originally came from Myanmar and then improved in Solomon Island and brought to Indonesia. Now we have a 5 year tick clone. And in Jepara, we planted 2 years ago. Now the height is already 10 meter. You could imagine 10 meter after 2 year old, and the diameter between 9 to 13 centimeter. So they were very happy with their tick in their backyard. It's important sometimes the farmer don't want to plant tick. Yeah. That's why we work in Jepara. Those who plant tick actually the small producer, the wood carver, because the farmers is they prefer to plant the sengon, Paracianthus falcataria. It's easier to grow rather than tick. But the carver, wood carver, they can carve the sengon, the Paracianthus. They have to work with tick, yeah, because tick is part of their culture. Yeah. Tick is not only trees, yeah, but also their culture, yeah, their cultural heritage. They have to work with tick.
Yes.
Thank you, Chair. I believe the result just presented by Harry is a work that's done by a consortium involving CIFOR, Porda, and what's the other, some other institutions. So when you said that there are some outcomes, like the improvement of the farmers, the small entrepreneurs' revenue, something like that, do you think it's also there is an interaction effect of the different part of the consortium done in Jepara? It's not just this singular research.
So thank you, Pak Putra. Sorry, I forgot to mention that the research conducted by CIFOR in collaboration with Forda and also Bogor Agriculture University. So we work together. And the direct benefit for Forda, for instance, there were junior researchers, now as a graduate, MS graduated, Ibu Nunung Parlina, Pak Putra. And also we took many intern from Indonesia, also from Wageningen, also from Uganda, from Ecuador, and also from University of Indonesia. There are many intern. If I'm not mistaken, there were 10 master student and also about 5 PhD student working together with us. Yeah. I think it's very, we were very happy to have them, and so they were very happy to work with the local community as well. So it's a,
thanks, Harry. A couple of weeks ago, we had a visit from the new IKEA forestry manager in the region. And IKEA is, of course, known for cheap furniture making of a certain quality level. And of course, the question becomes, what is the future of small-scale furniture industry when the IKEA expands?
Yeah. Last week we met with the IKEA. It's very, very interesting meeting with IKEA, and also we agreed to have several work together to do. And first is, if you see, we talk a lot about the certification. For instance, if you buy the FSC certified furniture, the cost will increase about 30%. Yeah. FTFT is about 7%. If LEI, the Indonesian Eco Labeling Institute, is about 10%. If SVLK, the Timber Legality Certification, is about 3%. So with IKEA, but IKEA mentioned to us that they can reduce the cost of certification because certification is part of the IKEA work. Yeah. But also I question why only FSC, not PEFC. They say that FSC is the IKEA way. Yeah. And the future is in collaboration is first IKEA is interested to have wood sources in Indonesia, also in Southeast Asia. We'll work together to map actually what the planted forest available in Indonesia and could join together with the IKEA. And also in terms of the small scale service under the discussion, because IKEA is a giant furniture industry, and 98% of furniture makers in Indonesia is small. How the link between big and small scale? Because we always believe they need work together. Because all small scale is quite difficult if we compete against China, for instance. We need to have a small and a big scale. And we believe with the help and collaboration with IKEA, I think it's very useful for furniture industry in Indonesia. But IKEA is not very interested in TIC now. But Patrick Salin mentioned this, why not in the future? But now they use more acacia, I think it's mostly acacia. But in the future, perhaps we can influence IKEA to produce solid furniture rather than MDF. But I think it's a good meeting, Peter. Thank you for having them to be with us here.
I think I wasn't clear with my question, Pa Harry. Actually, what I want to hear from you is that the impact of this consortium research must also have some relationship with the other component of the research which is done by the other members of the consortium. So what do you think when you said the smallholder entrepreneur that increase in income should be because of the other component of the research too, from the technology improvement from so that was my point. So thank you.
Yeah, thank you. There are several, actually at the same time, there are two projects in Jepara. First is more technological aspect, then by Melbourne University, CIFOR and FORDA and IPB is working more on the economic and certification and value change aspect. So we work together to, for instance, to have training in design and drying the wood, for instance. So there are, of course, several aspects. But from our project, I think one is memorial thing to remember is about planting the clone tick. Yeah. So we sit together, Pak, there between myself, Pak Rahman, and also Ibu Yofi from Bogor Agriculture University, and the decision whether we would like to endorse the clone tick to community or not. Yeah. Because there are research on that, but with different results. Some research mentioned that the clone tick is good, but some research mentioned that the clone tick is bad after the 5 years. Okay, let's make a decision, and mostly actually for the endorse to plant clone tick, fast growing tick. And this is the, we agreed, we are able to get here is a recognized forestry research institute. We have a FORDA, we have a CIFOR, we have Faculty of Forestry of IPB. If we cannot grow thick, who else can do it? So after that, we try to grow thick there and also monitor the growing of thick. But you're right, it's not only market, it's not only organization, association, but technology and also design. Because most value added of furniture lie on the market and design. If you have a bad design, then it's quite difficult to have a better value added.
Thank you.
Thank you. I think that it's a good illustration of the importance of working on the whole value chain. I mean, it's sort of what Pairi has insisted today in the 10 minutes is about the producer group, because it's something that is of particular interest to him, and he had only 10 minutes. But that's the whole issue. I mean, if you don't have the planting material, you won't have anything to sell at the end. So unless we work across the whole value chain, starting from the resource to the end product, we are unlikely to have any good results. And that's where the importance of partners that work in area where CIFOR is not working, and where in fact the consortium and partners and other makes more results than if we were acting alone, or FORDA was acting alone, or IPB was acting alone. So I guess that was the sense of the question of Paputra, that's the lesson, is that when we look at value chain, we should not look only at one section of it, because it's unlikely to work properly.